somebody had inboxed me and asked me to do Trouble in My Way. Amen. I may have enough to do that. Amen.
Oh,
this morning. Father, being here this morning, we count it a blessing to be in God's service. I want to say this morning we are still practicing social distancing. We're still practicing social distancing. We ask you to be safe, regardless of what your governor says. You see the numbers like I do, and I heard someone say one time, numbers don't lie.
That's right.
Numbers don't, they don't lie. And so he can say things are getting better, but numbers don't lie.
That's right. That's right.
Also want to be mindful to be in prayer for our country. We see things that are going on, that are taking place. Vigilantes, people want to be police, it's the different things we see, even in the state of Georgia. A young man by the name of Ahmaud Arbery, out on the job. Two people think that's because he's not supposed to be coming through their neighborhood. They want to arrest him and do an arrest and end up killing him, a 25-year-old black man.
That's right.
And I want us to say that we need to be mindful that there are some things that still exist in this great country that we call the USA. Address these issues. We cannot lay down and just look over it, because it could be your son tomorrow.
That's right.
So that's why we need to come together. We need to contact the people we have voted in to take care of us, to make sure that they're taking care of us. And also, we're going to see in this message today, there are some things you cannot wait. Then she fell on her face and bowed herself to the ground and said unto him, Why have I found grace in thine eyes, that thou shouldest take knowledge of me, seeing I am a stranger? And Boaz answered and said unto her, It hath fully been shown me all that thou hast done unto thy mother-in-law since the death of thine husband. And thou hast left thy father and thy mother and the land of thy nativity, and art come unto a people which thou knewest not before. The Lord will recompense thy work, and a full reward be given thee of the Lord God of Israel, under whose wing thou art come to trust. Then she said, Let me find favor in thy sight, my Lord, for that thou hast comforted me, and for that thou hast spoken friendly unto thine handmaid, though I be not like unto one of thy handmaidens. Notice here that Ruth says in verse number 13 is where we will pull our thought from. Then she said, Let me find favor in thy sight. Let me find favor in thy sight. This morning on this Mother's Day, I want to talk about being a woman of favor. Being a woman of favor. Because out of all the things that Ruth could have asked for, she said, Let me find favor in thy sight. Let me find favor in thy sight. Being a woman of favor. Being a woman of favor. This morning, my brothers and sisters, that I discovered that it's good to have a hookup. I've discovered it's good to have experience. But even though you may have a hookup, and even though you may have experience, it's better to have favor. Why do you say that? Because a hookup usually comes through people. And when people start acting funny, you don't need a hookup, you need favor.
That's right.
Because experience is only so good until somebody that has more experience than you come along. And when someone comes along that has more experience than you, you don't need experience in your life, you need favor. Because when hookups run out, when experience has turned and left you, favor can't carry you far. Because there are some times in life that where folk will hate on you because of the good thing that you have going on in your life, because of the blessing that God are allowing you to experience. And when folk start hating on you and folk start disliking you, you don't need a hookup, you don't need experience, but you need favor.
Yes, sir.
And I discovered this morning that when I look at the life of Sister Ruth, everything that happened in the life of Ruth, it happened because there was favor in her life.
Right.
And I think I need to tell somebody as I'm preaching this message here this morning that favor did not happen in her life by accident. In other words, there were some things that Ruth did in her life. There were some moves that Ruth made in her life that brought favor upon her life. In other words, she learned how to make it happen. And I believe this morning, Deacon McKenzie, that this generation of church folk that have this name and that have this claim and this rabbit mentality, I want you to understand that it's going to be something. And if I had a whole church in here this morning, I would tell them to look at their neighbor, Brother Wood, and tell them that Ruth was after something. And because she was after something, notice here in the text that she did not sit back and wait on it to come to her, but Ruth went after it. In other words, deliver me from passive people. Deliver me from passive women and who are so messed up because you're waiting on somebody to do something for you that you ought to be able to do for yourself. Now, y'all gonna help me here. In other words, if you want to get respect from a man, he needs to know that whatever he does for you, yes, you appreciate it. But in other words, if you don't do it for me, listen, we ain't gonna fall out. We ain't gonna stop talking because I can do it for myself. In other words, Ruth had a mentality. Ruth had a mindset that if you don't do it for me, guess what? I do it for myself. Ruth had a mindset that if you don't give it to me, guess what? I will get it for myself. In other words, Ruth had a mindset that if I had to be by myself to get where I'm going, guess what? I will.
Right?
So the first two people right here, Ruth the Moabite, said unto Naomi, let me go to the field and glean near the corn after him in whose sight I shall find grace. The Bible says she went and came and she gleaned in the field. Now watch this. In Hebrew, to glean simply means to pick up. But another definition, which is better, is to scrap together. Now what would happen is that while they were in the field, the reapers would harvest corn, and every now and then they would purposely leave some behind on the ground.
Right.
Now this is what I call the biblical welfare program. In today's terminology, no one had to tell Ruth, you need to go get an EBT card. Because Ruth says, I'm able to get up and do for myself, but I don't have to wait on nobody else to do anything for me.
Yes, sir.
So Ruth said to Naomi here this morning, the first thing about this text of finding favor, Ruth says, I'm going to do something about my situation. Which brings me to my first point this morning. If you are going to find favor, if you want to be a person of favor, sometimes you cannot wait for somebody to do for you, please let me pray, what you are able to do for yourself. You got to make up in your mind and listen to you. I'm going to get up on my do nothing and I'm going to do something about my situation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, some of you may not like this statement, but I got to tell you that your situation will always remain the same until you decide to do something about it.
That's right.
It's not going to change. Because you cannot conquer what you will not confront.
Mm-hmm.
Let me say that one more time. You cannot conquer what you will not confront. If I had somebody here, I would tell them, look at the names and neighbor, you cannot conquer what you cannot confront. In other words, there are some things in life that you are still going through. There are some things in life that you are still putting up with. There are some things in life that are still hanging over your head simply because you won't deal with it. In other words, the reason why your relationship is still like it is because you won't deal with it. The reason why your kids are still disobedient is because you won't deal with it. The reason why your house is still turned upside down is because you won't deal with it. The reason why you are not blessed but you are depressed is because you won't deal with it. Say that one more time, preacher. If you're going to get over it, first of all, you got to come from under it.
Right.
You want to get over that man leaving you? Get from under it.
Uh-huh.
You want to get over your friends turning their back on you? Get from under it. You can just get under it. If you can just get from under it. If you can just get from under it, guess what? What preacher? God will take you over it. Am I preaching with you? In other words, you got to learn how to switch places.
All right.
In other words, you have got to make up in your mind that I'm going from being under it because now I'm soon to be over it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord, I understand. Everything that's troubling me, I'm over it. Every negative thought, I'm over it. All my tears, I'm over it. All my pain, I'm over it. I'm over it. Ruth made up in her mind that neither me or Naomi, I'm going to spend another day like this. Watch this right here. She made up in her mind that me and Naomi are not going to spend another day like this.
All right.
Let me just help some of y'all that's watching this. There must come a time in your life. You got to make up in your mind that my life won't be like this always.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, please understand that that listen. That does not mean that in this life that you're not going to have to go through some things. That can simply mean that the level you're on right now is not the same level that you want to be in the next 3 years, the next 5 years, the next 7 years from now. Because when you come to that conclusion, you will learn how to do what's necessary to take you out of where you are and move you into a position, move you into a place where you desire to be.
Yes, sir.
So Ruth said to Naomi, I'm going to glean the ears of corn after him in whose sight I shall find grace or better favor. Listen, Ruth knew before leaving that I'm going to find favor with somebody.
All right.
Now I missed it right there. Ruth said, I know that if I leave where I am and I'm trying to get what God desires me to be, I will find favor with someone. So with that in mind, she left the field and she began to glean after the reapers. Now watch this right here. The text says that Ruth would pick up what the reapers would leave behind. She tried to find favor. She got to do something about her situation. But now she learns that if I'm going to find favor, that sometime I may have to dig. I may have to hammer. I may have to dig. I may have to have some leftovers.
All
right. Y'all missed it, right? Look at what she said. She gets up. She's reaping in the field. She's picking up what others leave behind. Now, those of us who grew up, those of us who are 45 and over,
right,
we know something about leftovers. Are y'all gonna help me here?
Right.
In other words, when it comes to cooked food, you don't mind leftovers.
That's right.
The artist Glenn Jones said that it's better the second time around. Are y'all gonna help me here? And some folks look at leftovers and they say, I don't want leftovers, I want something fresh. So y'all gonna help me here? But sometimes I've discovered that it appears to be fresh could just appear to be that way on the outside. Well, let me ask you a question. Have you ever went to the grocery store and you got some fruit that looked fresh on the outside, but after you got past the outside, you noticed on the inside it was spoiled? Just because, ladies, it looked fresh on the outside, it don't mean it's fresh. So what are you trying to say, preacher? Sometimes you got to learn.
Yes, sir.
Ruth said, just give me That's what the book said. Put that last part up there. The text said that Boaz and his father are having a conversation about Ruth. Which means if you're going to cause favor to come upon your life, you got to live the kind of lifestyle that when folks start talking about you, when folks start questioning you, you got to learn to keep your name positive.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Woo! Let me just help some of y'all. Because see, a lot of us, we got this thing mixed up. See, can I say that exceptional people, we know the difference between somebody that's saying something negative and somebody that's hating, and because of a fact. Okay. It's all right if folks are negative talking about you because of hateration. Hateration. That's the word for hateration. But can I help about five people? Hateration has never stopped and never will stop what God is doing in your life.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Hear the problem. Hear the problem. Hear the problem. Hear the problem, Brother Luke. The problem comes in because there are some things that folk are saying about you. They're not necessarily negative. They're not necessarily hating, but guess what? It's the truth.
All right. All right.
Please, Pastor. Listen, everything folks saying about you ain't a lie. And that's why when your name comes up, Priest Pastor, there's always so much negative. Because you always in something you ain't got no business being in.
All right.
And then you have to learn, you have the audacity that you want to lie now that folks are hating on you. Now, folks ain't hating on you, they just tell the truth. And the truth is, you missed it.
All right.
The truth is, you bad. The truth is, you two-faced.
Yes, sir.
The truth is, you can't be trusted. They ain't lying, they just tell the truth.
That's right, that's right.
I mean, they end up with that in here. But then Michael Boaz said in December, he said, I pray you, and she said, I pray you, let me glean and gather after the reapers among the sheaves. She asked me if I would let her have the leftovers. And Boaz said, I said, yes. Mm-hmm. Now, notice what he said. From the morning until now, she's been working. She's been working. She ain't, listen, she been working, Pastor. She ain't been messy. She ain't on Snapchat. She ain't concerned about TikTok. She ain't trying to take a screenshot, trying to show a part of her body, trying to get somebody else's attention. She got my attention, boy. Boy said, she got my attention because she working. Y'all missing this right here. She working. And boy said, the only time she stopped working was when she took a break and she went to the house.
All right.
And all I'm saying is if you want to find favor in God's sight, you got to learn how to be willing sometimes to work from sun up to sundown to get what you want.
Right.
And many people right now, not just mothers, are wondering why you keep missing your blessing. Can I just hit you right here? It's because you're not working hard enough and you're not working long enough.
All right.
In other words, even though God had the blessing for you, you got to be willing to put in some time.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because some things are not going to come easy. Ruth was willing to put the time in, and because Ruth put in the time in, the Bible said she was blessed.
Right.
Prove it, Pastor. Pick me up in verse 8. Then said Boaz unto Ruth, hear thou not, my daughter. Go not glean in another field. Neither go from hence, but abide here, fast by my handmaid. Look what he said. I'm gonna close this thing. Look what he said. He said, there are no men. you're in the right place. And some of you mothers, some of you ladies, you've been thinking that if I could just get in the right place, I'm going to get my blessing. You already in the right place. You just need to look for the blessing. Mm-hmm. I said you already in the right place.
Yes.
You just need to look for the blessing. Right. Okay, well, Pastor, I need some proof that I'm in the right place. Here's the proof. Romans 8:28 says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. Which simply means when you're living and operating according to purpose, things begin to work together.
Yes.
Let me say that one more time. When you're living and operating according to purpose, things begin to work together.
Yes.
So when purpose and destiny begin to regard your life, the Bible says that things will work out for your good.
Yes.
So I'm saying now, your life should no longer be about what you want. Your life should no longer be about what you want to know.
Yes.
But now your life should be more about, God, where do you want me to go?
Yes.
Because notice even this time, Boaz, he turns and he looks at Ruth. He said that I charge all of the young men.
Yes.
He says, do not touch them. In other words, when you find favor in the sight of the Lord,
yes,
the Lord will protect you. The Lord will take care of you.
Yes.
Because Boaz said that as long as you stay here, understand what I just said. They go upon that's formed against me shall be able to prosper. For somebody to go over, they probably will. He'll give you provision. Can I get a witness in here? Look at verse number 9. The Bible said that Boaz looks at Ruth and he tells Ruth that I know sometimes you're gonna get thirsty. But when you get thirsty, and I know without a shadow. Some of you right now, God's speaking to you and telling you, you need to stop doing this. You don't have to live another day like you're living.
That's right.
She got up and did something. And not only that, she said, I'm going to make it even if I got to make it off the leftovers. She's out there working. Boy, it's over. Thank you.